Oh no, this junky old tire is flat. What can I do? Enter Lasfit, air inflator. Let's see what's in the box, shall we? Kind of a nice, small package. It's a box within a box. We have an LED digital display, auto shut off, a pressure preset. It's compact and portable. That does seem to be that. A 12 volt power supply. Does it mean that it needs a 12 volt power supply? We're gonna find out. It's good for car, motorcycle, electric bicycle, bicycle, and ball. Not multiple balls, just ball. It's the model LAP CR1. The battery capacity, that's interesting that it has battery capacity, huh? It's 1.21 gigawatts. It's got type C charging. Output pressure is 150 PSI max. That's pretty high. And the weight is 250 grams. Made in China. Let's get this thing open. Have a look at her. And we have another box within a box. Actually, this is a pretty nice little carrying case, huh? Has a little strappy do for you. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, the top's kind of heavy because it's got all these cords in it. Let's see, we have a cigarette lighter cord, the USB charging cable. Here's the tubes. I'm not sure why it has a red and a black tube. I guess we're gonna find out here in a minute. It's got a little accessory kit. You got a little nozzle and a ball inflator. And I'm not really sure. I guess that's some kind of adapter. You know, it would have been nice if this was a Ziploc bag to kind of keep these in. But this, you just have to rip open and all your little tools are going to go flying like that. I can find me a Ziploc, though, to put these old guys in. And thank you for your purchase. Dear customer, Lasfit Air offers 24 months of warranty for your order. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us on Amazon. Our professional customer service team will respond quickly within 12 hours to help you solve any problems. Well, there you go. Using tips, the tire inflator is applicable to cars and SUVs with tire width up to 255. It's not applicable for large vehicles like trucks, vans, or off-road vehicles. Womp womp. It's recommended to recharge the compressor with a fast charging power adapter, which is not included in the package. Please prepare it by yourself. You know, I have some fast chargers that I've had really good luck with. I'll leave in the description below. If the battery is out of power, you could power the tire pump with the 12 volt DC power cord. And then we have some instruction steps here. Connect the compressor and tires with the hose. Long press the power button. Preset the tire pressure value. Short press to start inflating. The compressor begin to inflate the tires quickly. That's good. It will auto shut off once received the preset pressure. All your base are belong to us. And here's the manual. Could we possibly need to know anything other than what was in the little quick start guide there? We have precautions, which, you know, we don't follow because we're men. Goes over the buttons, goes over charging, goes over connecting the pipes and tubes, goes over the ball inflator. You can just check the pressure. That's good. It gives you some standard ranges for inflating. Tells you how to reset the pressure. Blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah. All right, let's get this thing out and take a look at it. It's got a nice little condom on the front. We'll get rid of that. And this is a nice compact little unit, isn't it? That's really one of the reasons why I wanted to get this thing, because it's just so small and handy. You can just throw this thing in your car. It's not gonna take up any room, carry it around with you. It's even smaller than a lot of the 12 volt inflators that I see come with the emergency kits in cars, you know? Nice and compact. And it's battery operated. How cool is that, huh? So looking at the instructions, I'm still not sure why there's a red hose and a black hose. You know, I think maybe it's just so that, you know, you can maybe use one just for filling up air tires. And then on your other hose, just leave your, like your ball inflator install or something. Maybe that, you know, I don't know. I looked through the manual and I don't really see anything saying that. So, but anyway, the way you hook up the hose, it's really simple. The ends of them have a little quick disconnect and it goes in this guy right here. You just push and turn just like that. And then for cars and anything with a standard shade valve, you just screw this right in. Press and hold the power button. It powers on just like that. We have a nice battery display up here. Here, if you hook it up to the tire, it'll display the current pressure. Let's get this thing hooked up and see what we see. All right, so the tire currently only has 3.5 pounds of pressure in it. I don't think we need that to get that out of the way. And I haven't charged this thing up yet. It's at half charge. I mean, I guess this would be a nice little torture test to see if it'll actually inflate this tire. even if it's not fully charged. It looks like it defaults to the car setting. It has some presets in here. If you hit this little M button, it goes to the presets. That's like a bicycle or a... No, that was a motorcycle. That's a bicycle. And that's a ball. And then this is just manual, I suppose. It's currently set to 100. Well, let's go back to the car. These guys, they only need 29 pounds of pressure. So this, you have this plus and minus button here. I'm going to like turn this down. It goes fast if you press and hold. But yeah, I'll put it on 29. Oh, and you see this button down here? There's a little light up at the top. You can turn the light on. Yeah, you know, it's reasonably bright. Oh no, this came undone. Ah, there we go. I must not have had it connected in there solidly enough. Oh, and to turn it off, you just press and hold the button. And it goes off. But this is what's really cool. Let's turn it back on. And it saved the preset for the last thing you set. Now to start pumping, you just hit this button right here. I'm gonna hit it. And let's start a timer and see how long it takes to actually get up there. Hey, look at that. All right. Well, we went from 2 bars of battery down to 1, but it's kept on trucking. Now, the hose here, this hose is kind of blazing hot, but the actual box itself, the little pump, yeah, this is nice and cool. I mean, obviously, whenever you're compressing air, it's going to heat up, but yeah, that's cool. So let me get this thing disconnected. It's definitely not going to win any races, but, you know, for a handy-dandy emergency tire inflator, it's really no better than any of the other units out there. And just the fact that it's battery powered, that's incredible, right? And also, it looks like you can plug in your accessories to recharge, like if you need to recharge your phone or something. And this is for your USB charging, and that's for your 12-volt backup. But yeah, I'm gonna take this over to the bench and put it on the charger. The charging cord it comes with could be a little bit longer, but you know, that's not too bad. Let's get this thing plugged in. It gives you a little blinking status light on the state of charge. Well, we've already gone from 1 bar to 2, so that's a good sign. Not really sure how long it's going to take to charge. Maybe I can come back in an hour and take a look at it. I might not wait to see how long it takes to fully charge just because, you know, don't have time to sit around and wait for that. But, you know, overall, I'm pretty impressed with this little unit. Kind of packs a big punch in a small package. And, of course, if you want one for your own, there'll be a link for it down in the description below. But yeah, this is definitely going in the emergency kit in the car. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button if you're not already. And give us a thumbs up, too. Helps the channel out. And it encourages me to do more tool reviews like this. So, see you guys next time.
Bonus footage.
I'll timestamp it here for you guys. And you can see when I come back in a little bit to check on the status of the charge. All right, time check. It's been a little over an hour. And it's gone from 2 bars to... almost 3. This third bar has been blinking for a while now. I've actually been keeping an eye on it. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and guess that it'd probably take a couple hours to fully recharge this thing, even on a 3.0 fast charger. But you know, I just can't get over how compact this thing is. Yeah, I'm really impressed. It's a cool little thing.